Welcome back, everybody, to the Pittsburgh Pirates franchise here on MLB The Show 20. As today, we continue the NLDS here in season number 5. More playoff baseballs. We have games 3 and 4 today against the Milwaukee Brewers. If one of these two teams wins both games, then the NLDS is done. And there would be no need for game 5. So there's a chance that this NLDS ends today. Game 1, we lost 6-4. All runs from both teams were scored in between the top of the second and the top of the third inning. Nothing before that and nothing after that. Jameson Taillon struggled. He didn't make it out of the third inning. And Noah Syndergaard, meanwhile, he did allow 4 runs in the second. But other than that, he was really good throughout his 6 innings. We knew we had to win game 2, and we did exactly that, beating the Brewers 6-2, including a 4-run first inning. Wander Franco's been very good for us. He's hit home runs in both games, whereas the rest of the team has a combined 0 home runs through 2 games. Joey Lucchese was really good. 8 innings. He did allow a couple runs late, but he was very good, and Victor Arana was able to shut things down in the 9th inning. So, thus far, it's been a pretty even series, as was pretty much expected, considering these are arguably the two best teams in baseball. So now we have games 3 and 4 in Milwaukee. Now the series is pretty much a best of 3 with the Brewers possessing home field advantage. A few things I want to talk about that are kind of random. One, Jose Alvarado went up like 4 ratings this year. His potential also went up by like 4, which is kind of odd, but he was really good. And O'Neill Cruz had plus 23 contact against lefties. Usually anything more than like plus 8 or 9 to an attribute is like ridiculously good. I don't know if I've ever seen more than like plus 12 or 13. This is plus 23. This is absolutely wild. I didn't point this out in a previous episode, so I figured I'd point it out here because it's kind of funny and kind of cool. And it's good to see O'Neill Cruz has ridiculous numbers against lefties, which is a little bit crazy considering he is a lefty. So let's end the chatter, let's end the anticipation, and let's get to the playoffs. Santiago Osuna, the 21-year-old, taking on Blake Snell here in Game 3. So certainly going to be a challenge for this Pirates lineup, taking on one of the best pitchers in baseball, but it should be a fun one. As I mentioned earlier, the series is now pretty much a best of 3 at this point. It's the first one to win 2 games, and the Brewers technically have home field advantage. Games 3 and 4 will be in Milwaukee, with Game 5 happening in Pittsburgh. Here's a look at both lineups. No Benny Lane today. Cabrian Hayes starting at third since it is a left-handed pitcher. For the Brewers, Omar Narvaez sprained his ankle. He will be out. So that's a pretty big deal. Narvaez always does really well against Pittsburgh. And it'll be Connor Hummel at catcher. So Blake Snell will be getting the start here for Milwaukee. He pitched in the wild card game, got the win against the Mets. Well, he technically didn't get the win, but I mean, he played really well. 7 innings, only allowed 1 run. So here's the first batter of the game. Pablo Cairo, weakly hit, broken bat, and he's still safe at first. Pablo Cairo, very lucky to get that single. First and second now, one away for O'Neill Cruz, who grounds it right to short. It looks like it'll be a routine double play. No, it's not. Keston Hiura overthrows the first baseman, Ronald Guzman. Pablo Cairo will end up scoring, and the error will cost Milwaukee a run. This inning could have been over with a double play, but with Keston Hiura overthrowing Guzman, a run scores, and it's now 1-0. It will only be 1-0 after the top of the first as Dylan Carlson strikes out. So, quite the start to this game. Certainly not what Milwaukee wanted, but I mean, Blake Snell did get in a little bit of a jam early, and if you have costly defensive blunders like that, then yeah, runs are going to score. So here is Santiago Osuna, his first postseason start this season, sub-3 ERA, another really solid season for Osuna, who looks to be the future ace of this staff once Jameson Taillon eventually regresses. As the first batter of the game, Lucas Davidson with a infield single. Now here is the following batter, Manuel Margot. He will go down swinging. Let's move forward now to the bottom of the second. 1-0 remains our score as Keston Hiura now goes down the outside cutter. Very nice pitch by Osuna. Santiago Osuna is not known as a strikeout guy, but he's striking out a few batters so far. Runner on second, 2 away for Connor Hummel, the new catcher. He gets walked. That will bring up Blake Snell, who hits it pretty nicely into right. However, Josh Bell will make the catch. So far, so good here for Santiago Osuna. 1-0 through two, and it seems like we could have ourselves a pitcher duel on tap if Blake Snell doesn't allow too many more hits. Let's go on to the top of the third now. Two away, nobody on for Josh Bell. 1-1 pitch, and this one's weakly grounded to third. Back-to-back, really good innings from Blake Snell. He is arguably the best left-handed starting pitcher right now in baseball, so if he continues to pitch this way, it could be a long day. Bottom three now. Here's Christian Yelich with a runner on and one out. This one goes off the tippy top of a wall. I don't know how that wasn't a home run. However, Yelich advances to second, Margot to third. Now there are two runners in scoring position. A prime opportunity for Milwaukee to capitalize. Miguel Sano will do what he does best. He strikes out. So it looks like Osuna's going to get out of this jam, right? Well, that would not be the case as Keston Hira rips this one into left. Barely going over the fence, but it does for a three-run shot. And the Milwaukee Brewers will take the lead as it is now 3-1. Osuna was pitching really well today. He had a bad inning, and Keston Hira was clutch. Hopefully, Osuna can pick things up as O'Neill Cruz going down fishing. A ridiculously nice pitch by Snell. And Duhar now grounds out to short. And Blake Snell is just dealing right now. As long as the Brewers don't pull off a Kevin Cash, then Blake Snell is going to be in this game for a while, and he is probably going to dominate. Bottom four here for Tyrone Taylor. This one is ripped high into left. Cairo chasing after, and it will drop. That will be a ground rule double for Tyrone Taylor. Davidson now up. He's going to check swing on the cutter, so Pittsburgh does get out of the inning. Score remains 3-1 through four. Top of the fifth now. Here is Osuna up at the plate. Hits it fairly nicely, but Keston Hira makes the play. Another quick and easy inning for Blake Snell. Four straight shutout innings. And I think the Pirates have gotten a base runner since like the second inning, so they are on a drought right now. Bottom five, Margot. Better double check that swing. That'll be the first out of the inning. Santiago Osuna continuing to get quite a few strikeouts here. Here's another one. Miguel Sano goes down swinging way too early on the low and outside changeup. So things seem to continue to be doing well in this inning. Keston Hira now up. He draws a walk. So now that there's two runners on, maybe Osuna's starting to get into a little bit of a jam. Ronald Guzman now singles it into right. Yelich will remain at third, and the bases are loaded with two outs. An incredible opportunity here for Tyrone Taylor, and he capitalizes, rips a single into center. Two runners will score. That is Yelich and Hura, and the score is now 5-1. A big inning here, a big hit for Tyrone Taylor, and the inning looks like it'll come to an end with Hubbell lining out to center. So five runs now for the Brewers. I would imagine this will end Santiago Osuna's day. He had three really good innings, but he had two really bad innings, and we'll see if that costs Pittsburgh. Top of the sixth now, Wander Franco now strikes out. Franco's not a guy who strikes out a ton, and he's been really good in the playoffs, so just Blake Snell continuing to be dominant. The lefty Caleb Ferguson will enter for his first postseason appearance of the year. Had a really good regular season for the Pirates as he strikes out Logan Davidson there. Let's go to the top of the seventh now. O'Neill Cruz leading off, and he rips a single into left. The first base runner since, I believe, the second inning for the Pirates. Now they have to capitalize with this runner on. Here's the following batter, Dylan Carlson. Hit it fairly nicely into right, but it is caught for the first out of the inning. Two away now for Francisco Mejia. He needs a big hit to drive in Cruz, and it is going to be caught. Here's a good chance that'll do it for Blake Snell. Seven innings, only one earned run. He was nothing short of dominant in this ball game, and he's getting a standing ovation from the crowd. Now it's time to see if the bullpen can hold on for Milwaukee and if their bats can get some more insurance as Christian Yelich strikes out. Lefty-on-lefty crime there. Another lefty-on-lefty, as this time it's Ronald Guzman who strikes out. So a good two innings for Caleb Ferguson. He did his job. Now it's time to see if the bats do theirs. Kevin Lenick will enter here in the top of the eighth for Milwaukee, and the Pirates are going to make a quick little change. Brian Hayes was due up, but Pittsburgh wants a spark, so they're going to put in Benny Lane. Benny Lane's not gotten an at-bat yet in this inning. 1-2 pitch, and it looks like this will drop for a hit. So it looks like the decision to put him in worked. If there's a time to start a rally, that time is now if you're Pittsburgh. Here is Cairo now. 2-2 pitch. He goes down on the slider. That one was right down the middle, too. Nice pitch by Lennox. As Dale Taylor will enter the game for Milwaukee, I'm a little bit surprised they chose to change pitchers now. But, oh well, interesting decision, and I guess it works out as Wander Franco will fly out to right. So the Pirates, again, are unable to score anything there in the eighth inning. And now we go to the bottom of the eighth. Ken Giles is in for the Pirates. I don't know why it says he has 50 saves. That's not true, considering he was only the closer for like the first half of the year. I think the rest of his numbers are correct, which is kind of odd. First batter of the inning, that's Taylor. He's going to go down looking on the 97-mile-an-hour fastball. Nice pitch from Giles. Here is Hummel now. He will strike out. Another K for Giles. Two outs now for Irsay, as this one is going to be flied out into right center field, caught by Cairo. So that will end the eighth inning. Can Pittsburgh have a huge rally here in the top of the ninth inning and keep this game alive, or will Milwaukee take game three? Alex Claudio will enter here for the Brewers. Two shutout innings so far in the postseason, as Josh Bell will lead things off for the Pirates. 1-2 pitch. He goes down on the changeup. I think the Pirates are used to super fast pitches from Blake Snell, so they're not used to these 70-mile-an-hour changeups now. That one was 71. It gets O'Neill Cruz to go down, and now the Pirates are down to their final out. It's Dylan Carlson, who has not gotten a base hit yet in the postseason. That one's hit pretty nicely into left center, but it will be caught, and that is how the game ends. The Milwaukee Brewers will take Game 3 of the NLDS here against the Pirates, and now Milwaukee just has to win one of these final two games, and they will move on to the NLDS. So now the Pirates have their backs against the walls. They have to win two straight against this really good Milwaukee team. The lineup was just not good for the Pirates today. They only scored one run, and that was because of the error in the top of the first inning by Keston Hiura. Only two hits, I believe, after the first and second innings, respectively. So just a rough game offensively. The Brewers' offense wasn't all that great either. They had a few big hits in the third and fifth inning, but outside of that, I mean, they didn't hit the ball that well either. Santiago Osuna had three really good innings. The bullpen was great, but Blake Snell just dominated, and the Pirates lineup could not overcome him. So that concludes Game 3, and now we have to go 2-0 if we want to keep our season alive. We have to win Game 4 on the road, and then we'll have to take Game 5 as well. So certainly a lot of pressure here. If we lose one of these next two games, our season is done. The 108-54 record would mean nothing. So I know that's a lot to take in, but this team can do it. They're good under pressure, and talent-wise, this Pirates team is probably better than anybody in baseball. So this lineup has the capability to have a big game. It's just a matter of if they'll be clutch. So here's a look at the lineup. Regular starters today for the Pirates. Again, no Omar Narvaez for the Brewers. He is questionable for Game 5. If there is a Game 5, keep in mind, the Brewers can just end it here without Omar Narvaez. And if the Brewers did have Omar Narvaez Game 3, would things have been different? Probably not, because Omar Narvaez is better than the backup catcher that they have. Brandon Woodruff and Jordan Yamamoto starting today. Let's take a look at Woodruff here first for Milwaukee. 2.32 ERA. He was outstanding this year for the Brewers. He's not quite as talented as Blake Snell, but he was more consistent this year than Blake Snell. Pablo Cairo hits it nicely to open up the game as Yelich with a ridiculous diving catch. Woodruff clapping, as well as the Brewer faithful. Well, that's one way to start off this game. Wander Franco now rips it into center for a single. Wander Franco continuing his offensive dominance. Josh Bell now up with one out. He hits this one nicely into the right center gap, but we got some base running woes. Wander Franco was very confused. He didn't know if Yelich was going to catch it, and yeah, things kind of got ugly from there. So Franco would be tagged out. It is a double for Bell, but instead of having runners on second and third with one out, it's now a runner on second with two outs, and the Pirates would not drive him in. So here's Jordan Yamamoto. He's been very consistent for Pittsburgh these past 4 years. His numbers have stayed pretty much the same as the Brewers ground into a 5-4-3 double play. That's Christian Yelich up at the plate. So nothing going here through one. On to the second. Another double play opportunity here, this time against the Pirates. And the Brewers do turn two there. That was Benny Lane who hit that ground ball. Bottom of the second now. Still no score here is Miguel Sano. He is swinging way too early. Going fishing right there. Didn't catch anything with that bait. The catcher, Cooper Hummel, now up. That would have been ball four, but instead he swings and misses for the strikeout. Top of the third now. Jordan Yamamoto up with a runner on. Going to go for the bunt, and it almost looked like the bunt worked perfectly. Nobody was there to protect first, but the Brewers do get the out at second. Wander Franco now up. Yamamoto on second with two outs. It's a single into right. The throw to the plate is not in time, and the Pirates will score first. An RBI single for guess who? Wander Franco. The pitcher, Jordan Yamamoto, is the one who scores. The Pirates now lead it 1-0. Yamamoto is the only run so far, and on the mound, he has been great. On to the fourth now. Here's Carlson. Full count with two outs, and this one looks like it could go for a hit. And it does. Dylan Carlson's first postseason hit of the season. It took nearly 3.5 games, but he's finally done it. Will he score now? It doesn't look like that one will be deep enough. It is close from Andujar, but it will be caught by Tyrone Taylor out in center. So the score will remain 1-0. It's been certainly a pitcher's duel thus far. Yamamoto and Woodruff have both been very good. As here is a nice single for Manuel Margot. Wander Franco kind of jumped a little bit late on that ball. So now the Brewers have a runner on here for Yelich, and it looks like he might ground into another double play. Two double plays so far for Yelich. He hasn't been very good outside of that really nice catch at the top of the first. So the Brewers, again, are unable to score anybody as we move on to the fifth now. Let's go to the bottom of the fifth here. Miguel Sano will strike out. Another K for Yamamoto. Cooper Hummel now grounds this one over to second. Franco makes the play. Both pitchers are continuing to dominate. Brandon Woodruff has been great. Jordan Yamamoto has been great. Both teams have some guys warming up in the pen, though. And it looks like Milwaukee has decided to take out Brandon Woodruff entering the sixth inning. I don't really know why they're going to take him out, because he's been really good. But, okay. Adrian Houser is the one who comes in for Milwaukee. Had a 6.3 ERA in the regular season. I'm baffled by the decision to take out Woodruff with how good he's been. O'Neill Cruz strikes out. Houser certainly trying to make sure that the Brewers do not regret their decision. But it looks like they will as Benny Lane crushes this one into right. It will go over the fence for a two-run blast. The first home run this postseason by the Pirates by a player not named Wander Franco. Two runs here scored through Benny Lane, and it is now 3-0. A huge hit here for Lane. Got that pitch right down the middle of the plate, and he capitalized. And I think the Brewers' puzzling decision to take out Brandon Woodruff looks even more puzzling after that. Brewers fans have to be very mad that Brandon Woodruff was taken out of the game. And now the Pirates have a chance to make this lead even bigger with Miguel Andujar up and one out. But he grounds into a double play ending the inning, but still a productive inning as the Pirates will triple their lead. Bottom six, much of the same from Yamamoto as he strikes out Ronald Guzman to open up the inning. Following batter Tyrone Taylor swings a little bit too early at the high and a little bit outside slider. And Jordan Yamamoto is continuing to dominate these batters. At this pace, he might go the full nine innings. Kevin Lenick is now in for Milwaukee. Let's see if he does better than Houser did the previous inning. One away here for Pablo Cairo, his second base hit of the day. This one is a single out into center field. So the Pirates have themselves a base runner and another opportunity to extend their lead. And it looks like Wander Franco might capitalize. This one is high and deep at center to the track at the wall, and it's gone. Two-run shot into straightaway center for Wander Franco, and his dominant postseason run continues. Three home runs now in the NLDS for Wander Franco, where, as I mentioned earlier, the rest of the team only has one, being the Benny Lane home run in the previous inning. And all of a sudden, the Pirates are up 5-0 with a very comfortable lead here down the stretch in Game 4. Huge home run for Franco. The Pirate base runners have been able to score with ease in these past couple of innings with these home runs, and Pirates are capitalizing whenever they get guys on base. There is Christian Yelich striking out after a Manuel Margot walk. It's been a rough day, as you can see, for Yelich. First and second now with one away for Keston Hira. That's a single into center, and the shutout is over. It took 6 1/3 innings for Brewers to get on the scoreboard, but they finally do it. And Keston Hira continues to be really impressive in this NLDS. So after that single, the Pirates would decide to take Yamamoto out. And although things were starting to get shaky here in this last inning, Jordan Yamamoto was phenomenal today. 6 1/3 innings, only one earned run thus far. We'll see if he allows either of these runners to score. Raisel Iglesias will enter the game here as Cooper Hummel, the first batter of the inning, will single it into left. So maybe it's not a Yamamoto thing. Maybe it's just the Brewers lineup is starting to get hot, as it is now 5-2 with the Hummel RBI single. Tying run is up. It's Tyrone Taylor. Two on, two out. He strikes out. Big K for Raisel Iglesias, and the Pirates are now in the driver's seat as we head towards the home stretch of this one with just two innings to go. The Pirates lead this game 5-2. Alex Claudio will now enter for the Brewers. Claudio continues to be really good here in the playoffs. Three innings, he's not allowed a run, he's not allowed a base runner. No walks, no hits, nothing. And that would remain a constant here in this one. A 1-2-3 inning from Claudio as Dylan Carlson grounds out. So the Brewers have two innings here to score three runs, and although their offense has not been very good today, they did just have a good seventh inning, so we'll see what they can do here, but it seems like the Pirates are going to have their best relievers enter the game. Carl Edwards Jr., with his second postseason appearance of the year, had a very good first game, I believe back in game two, and had a really good regular season as he opened things up with a strikeout on the pinch hitter Keon Broxton. Of all the players he can get to pinch hit, I don't really know why they chose Broxton. And then Manny Margot lines out to third. So a 1-2-3 inning there for Edwards. Pittsburgh up by three. I imagine the closer, Jose Alvarado, is warming up in the bullpen for the Pirates. Here is Dale Taylor into the game for the ninth inning. Just going to try to keep this game 5-2, not let the Pirates do anything crazy. And it looks like that will be the case. 1-2-3 inning as Cairo flies out to right. Yelich with the play. So the Brewers are down by three. Jose Alvarado will enter. But the Brewers have the meat of their lineup up. 3-4-5. And then Ronald Guzman as well comes up shortly after that. So the Brewers have their best players coming up in the most important time. So here's Alvarado. Like Ken Giles earlier, his save numbers are incorrect. I don't know how he can have 53 saves in 50 games. But the rest of his numbers are correct as Christian Yelich strikes out. Yelich went 0-for-4 today with two strikeouts and two double plays. Pretty rough game for him so far. Miguel Sano draws a walk, so Brewers now have themselves a base runner. Here's Keston Hira. 2-2 pitch. He goes down looking on the inside fastball. A huge strikeout for Alvarado, and now all the Pirates need is one more. It's Cooper Hummel, the catcher, up of the plate. This one is flied into right. Bell with the play, and the Pittsburgh Pirates win game four of the NLDS. So that means this series will be going down to a game five. All of the battles these past four seasons between these two teams essentially comes down to this one game, and I think whoever wins has the official upper hand of this rivalry in this franchise. So next episode is arguably the biggest episode of the series yet, and we've played six World Series games in this series. We have a World Series last year, obviously losing it to Cleveland. But I think next episode might be even bigger than any of those World Series games. So here's a look at the numbers. The Brewers did not hit the ball well. Two runs, five hits. We did hit the ball well, especially down the stretch once Brandon Woodruff was taken out of the game. And I definitely think Milwaukee regrets taking him out so early because he was doing so well. Hauser and Lenick each allowed two-run shots to Benny Lynn and Wander Franco. That's how he won this game. So next episode will be Game 5. As you can see, the Nationals have officially moved on to the NLCS. They officially beat the Padres 3-1. So if we win Game 5, we will have an NLCS rematch from last year. In the AL, the Angels have swept the Oakland Athletics, and the Rays currently lead the White Sox 2-1. So that will end today's episode. Next episode will certainly be a premiere. Game 5, Adonis Medina versus Noah Syndergaard. Pirates and Brewers, it all comes down to this. Hope you guys are ready. Peace out.